Creed, color, culture, or credential, there is unity in our diversity. There's an African proverb that speaks to us today, saying, the tragedy of life is not death, but what we let die as we live. No one more alluding to the death of our punctuality as we journey immeasurable miles commuting, not from home, but from our out-of-state parking spots. I'm actually talking about the truth in the adage that the opportunity of a lifetime must be seized in the lifetime of the opportunity. And we often don't know the opportunities we have until they're gone. But today, we celebrate and remember the inextricably intimate relationships we cultivated, the aggregate millions of hours we all spent studying really hard parents from us. And most importantly, the timeless legacy of integrity, excellence, and love that we are all a part of. First, let us recognize you, faculty and administration. You perform wonders in acting capacities far beyond your job description. You have distinguished yourself as intellectually impassioned students of pedagogy and prolific producers of scholarship. Moreover, you all decode hieroglyphic symbols posing as written answers on exams. You read papers blemished with the residual oil stains of calzones and Red Bull. I assure you today, you are better than your written my professor grade. Today is the day when you can look back on your career and find affirmation. As we prepare to take on the world armed with the rich cannons of scientific and philosophical inquiry, we thank you today. To my fellow students, I congratulate you all. You are a rare breed. You are like luminous stars in the universe, scintillating with the light of hope for our human family. Do not fear the daunting darkness of our world, for you are a light that will dispel the darkness with the radiance of your integrity and justice. Don't forget where you came from as you walk across the stage and receive that piece of paper. No, look at me now, self-aggrandizement. Remember that someone taught you how to add and multiply into your dreams. Remember, someone exhorted you to study assiduously first, and then use Wikipedia right before the exam. We must give back. You may not be called to revolutionize the world on a big stage, but then who said a revolution needed a stage? The revolution begins in you, and in me, and all of us who have been entrusted with the sacred charge to carry on the tradition of teaching truth. I once read a book in my freshman year titled Piti a Piti Na Rive by Margaret Cross. The title translates in Haitian Creole, "Little by little, we will arrive." In truth, family, little by little is how we got here. Little by little is the message that our first generation college students are living testament for. We celebrate you today. Little by little is also how our football team will improve. Don't stop believing, family. So let truth and love be our guide. In moments of crises, let us not be silent, but let us stand indomitably on the side of unarmed truth. So today we must declare that black lives do definitely matter. Yes, they do. Yes, ma'am. We also declare today that police lives do actually matter. We also proclaim today that our veterans' lives do matter. Those who are disabled do matter. Our orphans do matter. All of us matter. We matter. So we will not stand by and idly watch the systemic discrimination and violence against our fellow brothers and sisters. Yes, we are a great institution, and we must continue to be a trailblazer. We must progress until not only is URI 101 required, but so is Diversity 101. A space for intercultural interfaces, interlocution, for the intimate integration of our collegiate households. So let the culminating big thoughts of this university not be confined to the question, will we have money? Instead, let us inquire, will money have us? Let not esoteric whispers in the affluent halls of privilege intoxicate us with the love of power. Rather, let us be possessed with the power to love. Agape, unconditional. Let us not forget those in this very state whose voices cannot be heard above the celebration of our own accomplishments. Why? You ask the question. Dr. King beseeches us again, let us be dissatisfied until rat-infested, vermin-filled slums will be a thing of the dark past. And every family will have a decent, sanitary house in which to live. Let us be dissatisfied until brotherhood is no longer a meaningless word at the end of a prayer, but the first order of business on every legislative agenda. Let us be dissatisfied until our brothers and sisters of the third world, Asia and Africa and Latin America will no longer be the victim of imperialist exploitation, but will be lifted from the night of poverty, illiteracy, and disease. That's a good place to talk.